All right, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy anything. Just find happiness, be happy. That seems to be the mode of default life these days, is finding happiness. And it seems to be the common practice is to inquire of your mind of what your desires are and go try and fulfill them. And that works in a really excited way until you're about 35 or 40, and then you start to get exhausted. You start looking around and think, well, God, I've collected so many things, I've done so many things, and, you know, what now? Where am I going? And that midlife crisis happens. You start to wonder, God, all of this, and I'm just a cubicle rat, or I'm just in charge of cubicles, or as it goes, and round and round. And then as you start approaching old age, you just don't have the energy to maintain it all. And you start worrying about whether you gathered enough to take you through the remainder of your years, because fulfilling your desires has become very expensive, and you need a lot of money to retire on in order to maintain that style of living and that style of, or that level of hunger that you become accustomed to. And so I was reading through today this wonderful book called Practical Spirituality, written by Swami Lokeshwarananda. It's not enough just to be discontent. It must sharpen one's will to live fully, to live fruitfully for a purpose, if possible, for the highest and noblest of purposes. This means one must plot one's life course with care, know what one's priorities are, take every step deliberately, never losing sight of the goal that one has. This is mindful living. This is careful thinking. This is being very discerning in your plans and in your desires, in focusing your desires. It is not enough to have a worthwhile goal of life. One must also make commensurate efforts to achieve it. There it is, not just words or ideas. You have to manifest. You have to get out there and do. If one succeeds in an undertaking, it is not by a fluke, but by one's own effort. One is truly the architect of one's fate. There is no success that is worth having, which one can have without paying a heavy price. There are bound to be unforeseen difficulties in the way, but one is never deterred by them, but keeps fighting until all difficulties are overcome and the success is within one's grasp. This is possible if one has an iron will, a will that defies all difficulties. It is conceivable that there will be failures at various stages, but one still keeps trying, trying doggedly, refusing to give up the struggle. This is that zest of life, living for a wonderful ideal, and getting up and going forward, never being content to fail, never being content to fall down and just lay there exhausted. If your life isn't working for you, don't go suicidal and depressed. Think about it. Find another way. Come up with a different idea. Think about a fundamental change and go experiment with it. Life is about finding bliss, finding purpose, finding meaning, finding the mystery behind all of this amazing wonder. And there is plenty of amazing wonder.